Hello! We're back once again with another episode of Kane and Rince Streams. Obligatory move of microphone. There it is, they can hear me properly. Right, well! Now, normally I'll be sitting over there. But I'm sitting over here for reasons. Doesn't matter. Things. You can't see any of this stuff. I'm just a great thing and whatever. So, yes, Astro Aqua Kitty. Astro Aqua Kitty. Yeah, it's a bit of a tongue twister, isn't it? Made by Tiki Pod. Released last week on the Nintendo Switch. And be released on everything else. PlayStation, Xbox, Windows, PC, even PS Vita. Yes! This is a game that's coming out. I've been playing it for a little bit. I've been playing it mainly on a PlayStation, but I've got it on the Switch. I'm pointing at my Switch here, you can't see it. But I've got my Switch in front of me right here. And it's an extraordinary game. I've always loved the Aqua Kitty games. Aqua Kitty. Wow. They're great. And they've been around for a little while, and it's back again, this time with a whole new scenario adventure and stuff. It's just, you'll see this game and it plays and runs so well. It's just so well put together. It's awesome experience. I'm looking forward to streaming it with you. I decided to stream this late last week. I thought, it's just, you know, after streaming Steel Battalion last night, which didn't go terribly well, I'm not gonna lie. Technically it's fine, we're all running fine. It's just, I didn't do terribly well. I have to start over again because I just couldn't really put it together, which is really sad. But that aside, I haven't played this as much on the Switch as I have on the PlayStation 5. I've been playing it on the PlayStation 5. It looks and plays fantastic on every platform, pretty much. It's one of those games that kind of glows and shows itself off regardless of platform it's on, which is a good thing. What we're going to do is we are going to start a new game. Because it's important that you know about this. Because there's layers to this game. Excuse me. What layers do we have? Well, you have particular pilots. You can have particular pilots who have their own storylines, but also have their own abilities. So we have Heavy, who's like, you know, low speed, but tough armor and stuff. Scout pilot, fast and agile, but at the cost of slightly lower health. Chaos, smart and unpredictable, her energy recharge suits heavy weapons. So that's kind of nuts. And then there's Fighter, which is the one I've been playing with. So you know what? I'm not going to go with him because he's kind of an all-rounder and I quite like that. But I'm going to focus on something. I'm going to go with Heavy, I think. Then you get an engineer, repair engineer, who looks after your submarine, basically. He's got this sort of submarine that you're trucking around with, which is pretty awesome. And where are we? Stuff. Right. So, this one's skilled mechanic, specialised in all things repair related. So, she's an all-rounder. This one, protective, is into his armour. That'll work quite well with Heavy, I think. So, I'm going to go with that. I mean, it automatically sort of linked together anyway. So, let's go with that. We're going to do the difficulty levels right down to relax, right up to experienced and expert. I'm just going to go with regular because I prefer that. Then we have normal. When you die, you can restart from where you last saved. In permadeath, you have only one life, so if you die, you must start a new game. I'm not doing that. That's insane. I have died a couple of times. So we're in this asteroid belt. And okay, let's get straight to biscuits. HQ says our next job is in the system's asteroid belt. Our probes have detected vast volumes of liquid water within the large rocks. Huzzah. Curious energy readings suggest higher density of raw power gems and crystals to be mined. An advanced crew has already begun the setup and test drilling at the drop site. We'll land there and explore through these rock chunks, one at a time. And indeed, you do explore one rock trunk at a time, which is awesome. And yes, they're all cats. You are, yeah, just cats. There is one that a cat. So there are lots of jokes relating to being a cat. No doubt things like, you know, knocking things off shelves, judging, sleeping in sun puddles, that kind of thing. Thankfully, there are no black holes or suspicious aliens distress near signals nearby. This job should be a cakewalk. It isn't. I remember the last time we were told that. Yeah. So here we go. So, here we go. When you see this thing move, honestly, it's just so fluid. For good reason, but anyway. Here we go. So, oh yeah, as is tradition, what am I thinking? I am playing with my Nintendo Switch Pro controller, which is an excellent controller. It's currently plugged in because I don't want it to run out of batteries while we're playing. It's a safety measure. Not safety, just, you know, just in case. It'd be a bit embarrassing if the battery ran out doing this, you know. So anyway, there it is. That's the control I'm using. Try blasting these rocks. They sometimes drop raw gems which can be collected and traded. They can. Also shoot that orange supply crate that always drop a weapon or device which you can collect. Exciting. Here we go. Shoot. Collect gems. Shoot. Collect gems. Shoot. Cool. Now if you see, look at that moves. And how the little ship sort of like tilts every slightly as you go up and down. Just look at it. It's butter smooth. It's so nice. So nice. Have you got a plasma cannon? I can go to my inventory screen now. So look at all this. It's not just a shoot. Look at all of this. Look at it. Sorry, I'm getting excited. But yeah, so you can actually sort of put weapons in slots, and you got a cargo bay, and you actually put upgrades in here. You get devices. Oh, it's so good. And there's like stuff you can buy. You can upgrade your ship. It's got all of the things. And these are the abilities you can upgrade. Look at this. Sorry, I said that already. But anyway, you've got all of the things. You can add bonuses, and it's just so much. And there's a map. Look at the map. Look. Anyway, let's continue. I'm getting excited. There's a little dude. These are supply beacons that are sent out ahead of exploration teams. Let's deploy one so you can try docking with it. Ooh, here we are. Impressive. They have several uses. Please move over to beacons for ZL to dock. I'm not used to all the ZL and ZR thing because I've been playing on PlayStation 5. But doesn't matter. Let's dock the beacon. Oh, I want to save! Anyway, undocked, you can access the beacon shop and buy upgrades via your inventory screen. You can indeed. You start off with a lot of gems. And these apparently are random. They check your progress, exit your inventory, and press ZR of the beacon to save. Well, I'll do that, but I might buy something. Heavy plasma cannon, got one of those already. Energy generator, faster energy regeneration. And it costs 55, and strong hull, and that costs 64. I think that's just enough. Can I afford that? No, I can't. Mass is hard. Okay, so now I've got a high energy jet. This is a good thing. Right. So, and then we're going to save. Boom! Save. There you go. Let's just open the door. Okay, welcome to your base operations. As a commander, I can update on important matters such as mission status and snack inventory levels, which is much more vital than mission status. How can we help out today? Yeah. We just had a report. He's really polite, isn't he? We did a report of a tunnel rock fall which needs clearing. Let me show you on our map. There you go. So we'll go all the way over there to the right. Head over to the marked area. We will do that. But it won't be as straightforward. So this looks like a little shooter, but it really is not a shooter at all. It's a lot more to it. What's it say? You can check your controls via options menu, which I won't do because it's pointless. Saving a beacon's also refills your health and energy. It does. It's absolutely vital. Here you go. So, saving there, and so it says here, ahoy here, ahoy there. My batteries are stolen. Please return them so I can restore power to these doors. So it's kind of like an RPG. You get little missions to do, and you've got stats and stuff. Okay, so these little fellas. I've got my energy up, I've got my health up. I do like the little meow it emits when you get your stuff. And they sometimes drop gems, but not always. But I'm doing Mikhail proud here. My bullet dodging, gotta say. He's taught me a lot in the art of bullet dodging. The music in this is great. I hope I don't get shut off, actually. I just realised I left the music on. Never mind! Sure, it's fine. They're not as zealous as they were before. So here's one of the batteries. So I've got one of the batteries. Good stuff. There's a crystal. Oh, what's that? Something down there. Okay, so these are mines, and they explode like that, because mines have a tendency to explode. Oh. You need two pilots to drill, so I need to get... See, there's two slots in there for the pilots. I need two of them in order to drill through this wall here. So it's pretty cool. These little missions. So yeah, it's not just this... I mean, this bit looks a little bit like Xenon 2. Only the difference being this is actually entertaining. Oh! Oh! Shots fired, everyone. But, you know... Can't be denied. It's not the greatest game in the world, is it? It was just very pretty. That's my take on it, and I'm sticking by it. I mean, there is a secondary weapon. I haven't sort of shot that, but that uses up energy to. That's one, and that's two. There you go. Found them. So I'm gonna dock here to buy. Thing that I saw earlier increases maximum energy. True. Coffee machine, which uses all skill cooldowns. No, it's rubbish. Extra armor. He's already got pretty good armor anyway. Maybe I should save. I should save some money. I think I'm going to save the money rather than just spend it willy nilly. I haven't leveled up at all, but I will. When I do, I'll add some abilities. Okay, crabs have infested this hangar, halting construction work. No problem, we can clear them out. Totally can. Pretty tense. Remember to equip the... Yeah, no, I've done all that. Okay, well, how do I get in? Okay. I won't open that up yet because we've got to kill all the crabs. They're giant enemy crabs. Historically accurate. Are giant enemy crabs. It's a great reference to a particular press conference. There we go. Open up. So you can see how pretty the game is. I mean, brown is there, but it's the palette is very bright. I think it's sort of anchored around the colour blue, which makes sense because it is pretty much underwater. Oh, you dropped a thingy. How many have I got? 102. Very nice. Because that little purple line underneath is really important because that's what level I'm at. And that's really the key to success with playing Astro Aqua. Kitty, is that you constantly are monitoring your abilities and your equipment and your, you know, that kind of stuff. Very important. I think I killed everyone. Look, so it's got an exclamation point, just like in World of Warcraft. You know, the universal quest giver. You know, although, yeah, so there you go. Universal sign for quest giver. Crabs have now departed the hangar. Great, I'll hop on board. Hooray! So they're put on board, I think. Okay, so that's that done. So now, so if we go to map, yeah, I need to go now down. I have to go down here. So that's fine. So, I'll do a save, definitely. Then I'll dock, see if there's anything in there, in the shop that really I don't think it changes. But I am close to getting level 2, and I could buy that now, but I won't, because when you level up, you can increase your stats, like your ship upgrades, but that costs gems to do, so I'm not going to do that. I do like little numbers floating up above the things that tell you how much damage you're doing. And very, you know, yes, it's a bit Borderlands-like, but you know. And when you pick up like a little ability, you get a little meow. It's quite fun. Like this is a big one. Boom! Now you level up, but this doesn't make you automatically stronger. You need to go to a beacon and show you what. I can show you what to do, which I will do that, but not now. So unlike WoW, when you level up, you automatically, you know, get all your stats grown up and stuff like that. You've got to actually pay for the right to increase your abilities, which is a bit, you know, it's a thing, it's a mechanic, I'm okay with it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to head back now, because it'll make this life a little bit easier to do. So let's dock. What's that? SZR there. But let's dock. And when you level up, you can spend gems and upgrade your ship. I know. Do you see ship upgrades panel at the bottom right? You have enough gems, you can upgrade your health, armor, and energy. Totally. When you level up, you gain a point you can spend to gain a new skill. You can freely equip, unequip your skills while you're docked at the beacon. So, I can do reinforced hull, increase movement by 25. I might do that. Anti-bullet ring, shockwave ring which draws enemy bullets and torpedoes and mines. Homing jammer reduces enemy torpedo turn rate. No. Hardening shell armor increased by 20% more for a short time when hit. What's this? Close quarters. Enemy hit by increase by 20% if enemy is near. This seems tempting. I like these passive ones. Increase your ship armor by 25. I'm going to go armor expert. Let's do that. Cool. And I haven't. Oh, hang on. That's not right. I need to increase something. Help. Okay. Did I save? I didn't save, did I? Foolish fool! Yo. Nice. Yes. Like I said, I just love pretty much most things about games. It just ticks all the things I like. I didn't say the other thing, the cliche thing. No, I stopped. But it just really almost says this is a game made for me. It's great! Like I said, I've always loved the Echo Quickie games, but this is a great addition to it. And it's great it's coming out of the Vita, even though they're shutting down the store pretty soon. Which is sad. They're just like milk, but so far, puns are bringing up pale sludge. Oh well, it's worth a try. No milk pump here, better be focused on gem mining, I think. Yeah, it's pretty grim. Okay, but they've got these little milk pumps. Okay. What's down here? It's by a lone pilot, yes. Well, here's some strange bedrock we can't drill through, so we're making an extended tea break. Do you need help with something? We do! Hop in, we'll explain on the way. Cool. Oh yeah, they can't get through there. Is there anything of note down here? Not really. No. It's always good to explore in games like this. It's always a good idea. I mean, you get experience points for killing things, so it's always good to do that. The lighting in it. Something I do talk about in games, I freely admit. I do like the lighting. Right, I've got 103 gems, so I'm going to dock and I'm going to increase my armour. Okay, so maybe I can go here. I know what's coming because I've done this already a few times now. I think I've done it once on a PlayStation 4, once on a PlayStation 5, and once. Yes, that's three times I've done this boss battle. So I think I'm pretty good at it right now. But I'm sort of anxious to do it. I'm not sure if I've got the right equipment. I'm going to check that in a second. I might do something. Oh well, let's just do this. There we are. Rocks, right guys. However, is there a problem? This machine needs external wireless power. Transfer energy to it by keeping close behind. We will do that. There we go. I love the little lights behind the drill. It's so, all the little details. That's what I love about this. It's just wonderful. Really good stuff. Here we go. Hold on, we'll just hang out here for a bit and eat snacks. No, they took our snacks! They did, they totally did. Just, you know. So yeah, you just press the little shoulder buttons and you just rotate, it's cool. Work on a new type of walker vehicle, we need some parts to help make the legs. Slick rig, how can we find what you need? The dead husks of large robo crabs sometimes drop useful salvage and destroy. Go see what you can scavenge. Okay, sure thing. We'll take a look around. I'm going to save it here because I can't upgrade anything. Damn it. You'll get slight sort of health regenerations too, which is very, very forgiving to do. It's very nice. So I'm just trying to get rid of all these enemies so I can blow away these rocks. So this is currently out on Nintendo Switch, and it will be out on all other main platforms in the next couple of weeks or so. Give or take. Yeah, just really, really blown away by this game. I'm trying to finish Assassin's Creed at the moment. I'm really, really close, but this game has distracted me from doing that. So fair play to DigiBod for doing that. I've got a lot of that. Here we go. all blowing up now. Let me get down here. Ooh. Over the top for those particular enemies. I don't need to. So I picked up a laser weapon once when I was playing the PlayStation 4 version. And it drained all my energy and I couldn't shoot anymore. It's a bit odd. I like those torpedoes. Not when they shot at me though, but. RJ! Yeah, looks great. Love the contrasting and cool music as always helps. Yeah, it's everything about this. I find it very difficult to fault this game. I really do. Now, I must confess, I am interviewing a developer really soon on the Sausage Factory, so that's going to be cool. I just realized I've missed something down here. Yeah, I should have picked that up. Oh. My bullet dodging needs to get better. Really does. Look, more things. You've got to be really, really tall because you can just float by things. Oh yeah, no, I don't need to know about that. I need to worry about that. I've got 245 gems now, which is brilliant. Looks like I can buy a load of stuff before I take on the boss, which is imminent. Go there yet, because I've got that arm. I just dinged. I heard that. I dinged. But I think I should get out. Because that's one of the things this game does really well, is teach you a little bit about risk-reward. Save something. There you go. don't do anything. So I'm going to... I'm up to level 3 now. Which is pretty cool. So what's this? Beam extender. That means if I've got a laser beam, which I'm not using at the moment. Mine layer, explosive mines. Okay. It's not really my thing. Gem cutter. Let's grab that and put that in there. That's fine. I've already had that anyway. Energy generator, that sounds like a plan. Ooh, that'll make me go faster. Cool, that's good. Do need to increase my health though. Do that. There you go. But yeah, I love this, all this upgrading stuff, and it's just this makes it so it's much more to it. Which is a good thing. Yeah. So but I'm going to keep going. The other side. Oh, yeah, there's some there, look. Look on the map, it just tells you where the rocks you can break out are. There's some there. Ooh. Excellent. These enemies appear to regenerate. I'm okay with that. Really needed that. Oh, proton charge. Let's see what that is in a moment when I finish blowing these people up. Loads of money, loads of gems. I'm going to stream until I kill the first boss. That's my idea. I should do it within the hour, although I am actually in true Cane and Rinse fashion, Cane and Rinsing this level. Speaking of Cane and Rinsing, I'm currently going through Assassin's Creed Valhalla, and I'm 138 hours in, a bit specific number, but it's been a very long time since I played a game for that long. Really, a very long time. It's been, I mean, it's weird that I'm finding myself actually like almost prolonging it deliberately. It's a bit strange, I've never done that before, but I'm like, I can finish it sooner than I want, like, you know, I choose, but there is one of the things. Just want to make sure that there's the other arm. Another arm. There you go. That's what I was looking for. But I'm enjoying the game so much, Assassin's Creed, that is, that, you know, decided I'll keep playing then. So I'm actually doing, I mean, I killed, I can't advance anymore, but I'm just like almost prestiging the game, because I'm getting all these like skill abilities and stuff, and it's just like, yeah. So, it's getting a bit, there's not much challenge to it anymore because I can't, nothing can really stop me anymore. There used to be. So I've got three arms now. I think that's what I needed. $704, my goodness. So the game rewards you for exploring. That's a true fact that I can back up. So be really observant and blow as many of these rocks up as you can, so you get all the gems. Gem. The map really helps because it tells you where they are. You do need to update your weapons, otherwise the enemies it throws at you become so unwieldy you just can't hurt them. So this I like that. Like a game within a game. It's a good thing. I mean, it does like tendency to min-max and stuff, but there it is. Does Leon let you play audio games as well? Does he let me? Yeah. No, I'm not playing Assassin's Creed for Cane and Rinse. I'm just playing Assassin's Creed. I'm enjoying it. I'm actually genuinely enjoying it, and I'm just, it's been the first time since I actually I want to go to here because I'm going to buy loads of stuff. You can recycle things as well. There's no level 3 weapons here, which is rubbish. The plasma shotgun, I mean, it's a plasma shotgun. Don't like shotguns in games. I'm not kidding. I don't like it. I didn't like it in Doom. I know, heretical, but there it is. I'm going to grab this level 2 thing and turn this off and put this on. So I've got more of that. And what you can do is you can actually recycle things. So, yep, you can recycle stuff in your inventory you're not using. Proton charger, very powerful but limited shots. I'm thinking that if I get rid of this and add that there, that would be a good thing. And then I can replace this. Yep, it's only get 6 gems, but it's better than nothing. I've not got the beam, I don't want the mines, that's a bit rubbish. Armour, I can put that in, there you go. Yeah, I just realised what you asked there, RJ. But yeah. Anyway. Where were we? Skill of our ding! So, anti-bullet ring. Reinforced hull. Let's just keep going with the increasing the armour. Wow, look. I'm way over on the other side of the map now. There is a little red cube down there, which I need to deal with. So I'm going to pop down there and get that stuff. Because that's what, you know. What's this weapon like? Oh, blimey. That's going to come in handy on the boss. There's loads and loads of weapons in this game. So me not knowing and seeing that before, that's just really adds testament to that. All of the gems, all of them. I mean, I usually get like a torpedo or something, which is really handy against this particular boss. But we'll see how this one goes. I'm gonna check my inventory. That's what I like to pick up. I think it was this. Volley, oh no, the volley one. I'm not keen on that. It just doesn't do continuous fire. I prefer continuous fire. So, anyway. So let's save. That needs to happen. This game is what film Cocoon should have been, rather than old people feel young. Yeah, I'll go with that. Destroy enemies sometimes drop orbs and restore energy. They totally do, yeah. Right. Something attacked us. We had to flee the drill site. It's the boss fight. Right. Spoilers, but there it is. Don't worry, we can take a look. We'll have to look outside, of course, for our own safety. Thank you, I think. Yeah, this is bad. Sometimes, yeah, okay. So now I've blown it up. And now it's just this. I am hurting it. Look at that. Look at that bullet nightmare. But it's like a slow regeneration. Ow! I'm gonna get my slow regeneration of my purple cannon thing. But he's hurting. He's hurting. Honestly, I've got Mikhail to thank for my abilities to do this now. Because back, you know, previously I just got lost patience. But he has taught me the idea of you just take your time and eventually you will win. It's just recognising a pattern and sticking to it. There you go, one boss down. Glad that's all over. Yeah, I'll spin the next warp bubble in 3, 2, 1. Just move in when you're ready and jump to the next area. I'm going to pick all this stuff up. Before I go here, because this is a bit hairy, I'm going to go to my inventory screen, see what I picked up. Picked up something. Oh, there it is. Long life bots. Increases skill box timers and health. I like the sound of that. Right, I need to shut something off though. I don't know. Turn that off and put that in. There you go. Ding. Ding. Did I? No, I didn't. Anyway, let's go! So, got Sargasso. Yeah. So I'm playing on normal difficulty, by the way. If you're thinking, that's a bit easy, Chris. It's not normal difficulty, regular difficulty. And I don't actually know the systems of the game. I'm quite familiar with it. I say quite, that's a bit arrogant. But you know what I mean. I've been playing this game for a while. So I know it's little how it's designed. Anyway, so that's why that was relatively straightforward. But honestly, when I first encountered that when I was playing it, I did actually screw up quite badly. And then I realised, no, Chris, you have to become one with the boss and really just spot the patterns and avoid the bullets and shoot when you don't just randomly spam bullets everywhere. That doesn't work. So, right, hold on there. I just need to remote launch a beacon. There it goes. Woo! They move fast. Anything we can help with? We have a new science lab rigged up at the centre of this asteroid. Head right and ask them. You can't miss it. Very true. So you can see, we look at the map anyway. So yeah, we're on the far left over there. We've got to go across to the right. Lefty-righty shooter, kind of-ish. So you see these things are everywhere. And they're really tough. I mean, that's fine. You don't have to shoot them. But there's lots of really nasty memes in this particular level. There's a mind-laying dude. Hello, this door is basically the mechanic to fix it. We do indeed. I know that. I'm just popping down there to show you what I've got to do later. I've got to make it my way. Yeah, I can't really take him down with the torpedo thing I've got going. So those things, when they blow up, they leave a residue. Sorry, I'm gonna pop in here to dock. Anything I can buy. So they got different shop. The shop's got more powerful equipment, but I can't use any of it because it's got red numbers like 4, 5, and 6 and stuff. Classic ring projectiles. Yeah. 8 areas in total, it seems. I don't. Yeah. 8. Is it 8? Yeah. I think it's. No. It's a lot more than that. It starts off with that, and then it gets. Anyway. Spoilers. So I've got this little laser. Is there any laser I can buy? No, not really. Not really. I'm gonna recycle this though. So yeah. There we go. I'm not gonna use this. It's rubbish. Yeah, I'm not going to use it. So that can go. These decisions you have to make all the time in the game, so you're just constantly monitoring what you can do. I'm already using one of these, so let's get rid of the double up. Oops. I'm not using this anyway because I don't use a laser beam. I'm not using that. I may sell it. Let's leave it in there for now. But 789. That's just awesome. Saving, and then I'm going to chat to this person. This is a fancy new lab. Sure is. It will help us examine unusual biomechanical wildlife that is found in these asteroids. We'll also show you around a bit, but the main power is down again. Oh, it's the worst. That was a leading statement, so thanks, Chris. Anytime, RJ. Anytime. No, it's, yeah, it's, there's a lot more to this game than what we're showing here. So head up to Sector A. So you see this little map here. If I just go here, there's maps, you look, there's a little bit area above and below. So let's go above first. We'll go to Section A, because that's what it says. Look at these little fleets. I love these. Even though they're trying to shoot me, I think it's just, look at them. It reminds me of a lot of games. Good ones. But yeah, anyway, I'll stop gushing. So these like poison cloud things are pretty nasty. And then to avoid those, it's very easy to get trapped in them and lose a lot of health. And these things are horrible. Barely taking any damage from my bullets. There you go. But it's in my interest to actually. Yeah, they're firing off. Oh, nasty. This is horrible. Who are you? Mechanic crew, I'm trying to open a plant like doorway but can't get it. The buds are normally most problems. Do you have a problem? More than I can list. Okay, let me help for a bit. Nice, we've got a mechanic on board now. We can fix doors, apparently. Yeah, these poison things are really nasty. So easy to get trapped in them. Look at the poison clouds. It's really wonderfully done. You can see them. White. Very clear. But you can see, it takes forever to kill these things. And they're shooting these big round circle things. Hurt a lot! There you go. Oh, there's some rocks up here. I don't really need that many gems, but there it is. This game really pops out on the Nintendo Switch screen, by the way, in case you're wondering. Most games do, let's face it, but especially true with this game. So it plays really, really well when played in handheld. Although I must confess that I haven't been playing handheld mode on my Switch for quite some time, mainly because no one's travelling anywhere. yeah, most of my Switch game is on the big screen, mainly docked. The moment. I think that's the same for most people these days. It's really tempting to sort of dive in as you kill things with those, but you shouldn't do that because you get hurtsies. Oh, ow. Pass on through, I will. Thank you very much. I'm about to ding, and I need to ding to get those additional weapons and stuff. Sonic gun. Find out what it has in a second. Ding! Hoorah. Let's go and sort myself out after I've done. So, I'll do a skill in a minute. Let's just do the upgrades. There you go. So now I've got these. I can buy these. So these are dual spread shot single changes as you move. I've had that. Plasma cannon, heavy shot but slow. Yeah. And then this is the Sonic thing. And I picked this up, didn't I? But so I've already got one of those. I'll get the energy transfer. That's a thing. Turn that off. No, that one's fine. Turn that off. This one. And then recycle this one. Do you know what I mean? It's lots of inventory management and stuff. Not quite as bad as a certain science fiction game from the early 2000s. But now, should I buy this thing? Should I try that? Or should I get that instead? Plasma cannon. Heavy shot but slow. We did have that before, but let's try. Take this off. There you go. Let's try this. What's worse can happen? Skills! Close quarters. So I'm liking that. Hardening shell. There you go. Oh, I better save. There's a similar setting to so many classic and some new games, but the choice to set underwater on asteroids allows for a variety of different approaches to levels and enemies. Really innovative. Yes! Yes, it is! And it's so well put together. Even the data accessible and uses simple colour coding. Yep! Going, there was a door, wasn't there, that I need to get open. This is the one. I need that gem covered in poison. There you go. If I shoot too much, I run out of energy, you see. But I've got a level 4 battery that regenerates stuff. It still looks damaged. I'll just pop out and fix it. Should be a quick job. It will be indeed. There he is. Look, and it's like, oh no, you've got to defend him now. But it's okay because I've killed everyone. So all good. How's it going? Done and dusted. There it goes. I like the way the bullets explode. These are one-shot hits right now because of this gun I've got. So I'm running low on energy. That's a problem. Anything in the shop? Is this the laser beam thing I was talking about earlier? Not keen! You lose a lot of energy. The practical lighting effect, the deeper you go, is very clever and effective. James Cameron is defo playing this. Yes! Yesterday, yes, he is. I'm gonna buy this. And this. And I'm gonna disengage that and add that. I'm gonna disengage that and add that. All about making sure your equipment is aligned with your level. This I've known this for many years, but same thing with Assassin's Creed, sort of go on about that, but that's the same thing. Your abilities go up, but your equipment has to match those, has to match, just to walk in step. And once you know that, the game becomes much more not palatable, but easy to get through. I'm going to save there. Cool. This is new. Ooh. Plasma gun. Let's have a look at this. Oh, it's a plasma gun, but it's level 5. How far am I from halfway through to level 4? Come on. I'll definitely keep that though, because I'm going to be using that. So I've got a level 1 one there. I'm going to delete that one. I'm going to recycle it for some gems. Gem. I'm out of energy. That's bloody grim. Yes, mortars are really annoying. Oh, I've got no energy to shoot. Oh, this is really annoying. Let's just check my... Yeah, I've got energy generator level 4. Yeah, it's all there. Oh, we've reached the hour! We have reached the magical hour. Dock, nothing in there. Okay, we'll just save it there. We have to call it there! I know it felt like 10 minutes, but no, we've reached the hour. Fantastic game. Cannot recommend it enough. Hopefully you can see my, how compelled I was throughout this experience. It's really good. No, in all seriousness, really, really good game. And we'll be back next week with another game of some description on a platform of some description. It doesn't matter. But it will be a game. But until then, goodbye!